Sir, can we start?
Yes, sir. Yes,
Okay,
sir.
sir.
Definitely.
Okay, sir. Okay. So, very good afternoon, all of you. Mr. Oira Kharewala, sir, dear learners, Miss Minati. So, today, sir will take class on Management Information System. That is a very important subject in management, which is a combination of management and information system. Both. So, I request Mr. Oira Kharewala Parida to start the session. So, please, sir, start.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Dear learners, here I am discussing regarding the management information system, which is a very important content, as I told you. Now, thing is that information system and management, when comes together, it creates another level of technique. Now, management, some people are studying management, some people are studying information technology, right? Now, whenever those two things are integrated, then we combine the quality as the management information system. Now, before that, in your school classes, you might have read the human systems, human, like your human digestive system, human reproductive system, and so on. Now, first of all, what we will see, what is system, what are information and what are data. Now, in the world, the current situation in the world, the most important and precious thing and the vital thing is the time, and the another thing is your data. Now, if somebody has data and somebody has the time, and he or she can appropriately use those two things, then he or she will be the one of the richest person in the world. Now, if you take the examples of the richest person in the world, they are not being just like richest persons. They are using the data and the information in such a manner that information and the data, along with the combination of time, generates the revenue for them. And that revenue stands them number one, number two as the richest person of the world. Now, coming to our topic, now what is data? Now, data is something, the facts what you are collecting in the environment, right? The after filtering of the data, it's converted into information. Okay. Now the facts and the statistics collected together for reference for analysis, that is called the data. Now examples of data. Now examples of data are the information collected for the research paper. If somebody is doing some research regard for the management and collecting the data from different sources, now it matters. Rarely it matters that all the data is relevant for his thesis work or for his research work. Now the researcher, what he did, he just filtered that data and take the required data, what he requires, and that required data converted into information. What is the second point is given is information. The information is the knowledge regarding the particular thing. And the particular knowledge regarding the particular thing, how you will acquisition that knowledge? Whenever you are acquisition the data regarding the particular thing, then you acquisition the knowledge. Now knowledge keeps the track of information. Now examples of information. Now what gives to someone who asks for background about the something? For example, if the principal asks to the teacher, now give the top five students' name who are standing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the position. Position means has secured the top 5 marks. Now the teacher or the HOD gives the information regarding those students. Now sir, this is the Ram who secured the first position. This is Sam who secured the second position. And regarding their family, regarding something in their family, their background, all sorts of things. The information what the principal wants, the teacher gives to the principal. Now principal extracts that data into information that yes, the name of the first student or the first position student of the class is Ram. Now coming to the another important aspect of the system. System means, for example, consider you might have heard the, in different fields that सिस्टम में गड़बड़ी है, सिस्टम तो करप्ट है, हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं, वी आर द पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम, हम चाह के भी सिस्टम को बदल नहीं पाएंगे। होता क्या है ये सिस्टम, व्हाट इज द सिस्टम, इज सिस्टम इज नथिंग बट द कम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्मॉल 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 थिंग्स टू एक्वायर और टू फुलफिल अ पर्टिकुलर एम, राइट। नाउ इफ वी आर थिंकिंग अबाउट आवर इंडिया, नाउ द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ ए गवर्नेंस इज टू गिव गुड हाउस टू द पीपल, टू गिव गुड मनी टू द पीपल, टू गिव गुड शेल्टर टू द पीपल, गिव गुड फूड टू द पीपल, ऑल सच अ थिंग इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अ गुड गवर्नेंस। नाउ हाउ द गुड गवर्नेंस विल फुलफिल, टू फुलफिल दोज थिंग्स द गवर्नमेंट हैज द डिफरेंट सिस्टम एंड द डिफरेंट सिस्टम एक्ट्स लाइक ए वर्टिकल्स ऑफ द गवर्नेंस। नाउ दोज वर्टिकल्स इफ वर्क प्रॉपरली देन द वी से दैट द सिस्टम इज वर्किंग प्रॉपरली। इफ समथिंग इज हैपेंड एंड समथिंग इज डिफेक्टेड इन साइड द पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम देन वी से दैट सिस्टम में गड़बड़ है, यहाँ पे करप्शन ज्यादा होता है, यहाँ पे काम नहीं हो पाएगा, तुम अगर पैसा नहीं दोगे तो यहाँ कुछ नहीं हो पाएगा। दिस इज द थिंग व्हाट वी आर जनरलाइज द थिंग इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस। नाउ एग्जाम्पल इफ यू थिंक दैट द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड हैज द न्यूमरस काइंड ऑफ सिस्टम दैट इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड डेली लाइफ, सम एग्जाम्पल्स इंक्लूडिंग ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम। ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम इज नथिंग, इज नॉट ओनली इंक्लूडेड अ बस और अ कार और अ जीप। Transport system is included the RTO office, the minister of RTO, ministry of RTO, the permit, route permit, the bus, the owner of the bus, lots of things when grouped together, then we call it as the transport system. The solar system, the sun and the all the planets revolving around it, we call it a solar system. But a single single planet, we call it as a single planet, not a solar system. The earth is a part of the solar system, right? The telephone system, digestive system, these are one example of the system. Now, the main important PPT is here, the data, information and system, which are the three verticals, important verticals of the management information system. Now, please remember the data, information and system. Those are the three important aspects that you are currently reading. Now coming to the our topic, what is MIS? Now, MIS, as you all know, that it stands for the Management Information System. Now, what do you mean by Management Information System? Now, management has different verticals. Now, we will catch those things in next slide. Different verticals management have. Now, think is that if the management runs a particular organization, now the objective of that organization is nothing but to increase the revenue or to serve the people in such a manner that people or the customer will satisfy. Now, if you have lots of customers and if you don't give them service in particular time, then the customers are dissatisfied. Now for that reason, what you will do? You must adopt something new technology in your system. Now, what are the new technology? This one of the examples of that new technology is the MIS, Management Information System. Another thing, what you will do? Now, you might have heard the database management system that you could also implement. Another, what you will implement? You could have the applications like your app in the mobile phone, like a website in the computer or your mobile phone. Lots of things you can implement as a manager or as a top manager of the company so that your customer will attract towards you. And if customers attract towards you, then your revenue will increase. Then if your revenue will increase, your employee gets good satisfaction and the employee gets good salary and the organization will grow rapidly. The growth rate of the organization will in a very accelerated manner. Now, management, we learn about if you are the manager. Now, coming to, what do you mean the management? How the top manager manages the thing? How can you define what is management? Management is an art. Just like, let's say you are preparing a chicken curry, right? Now, chicken curry, you all might have who knows how to prepare or who don't know how to prepare, they know that the main ingredient is chicken, and the paste of the ginger garlic, the onion, the oil, the salt, and all the masalas what you have there, and you put it into a into the bucket, sorry, into the kadai, and you on the stove and you prepare the chicken. Now thing is that if everybody knows how to prepare the chicken, now can you agree to eat a person who don't know, who said that I know the recipe of the chicken but I don't know how to cook, and if you insist me, then I will not take responsible the taste. Will you able to give that person, yes, please, we are agree, but then you cook the chicken. Definitely we will not agree for that reason. Now we know what is management, but thing is that it is a type of art, like cooking is a art, like the organizing the thing is a art, like developing an website is a art, like creating a beautiful website. Here we have
the
organizing
the thing is a art, like creating a beautiful website.
Sir, can I audible? Himanshu, sir, I am audible.
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir. Hello.
Somebody, please give me the
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You audible, sir?
Audible, audible.
Somebody, please respond that I am audible or not audible.
Learners, please say something that sir is audible or not, please. Type a message at least.
Yeah. Because there is a phone call. That's the reason that the disconnection of.
Now I am audible, sir.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yeah. What happens there in the phone? Sometimes the call is calling and the Bluetooth device is not acting properly. So that's why I asked.
Yes, sir. There's this message. Prasant Kumar Barik said that yes, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. Now,
okay,
sir. Okay. What I am talking that management is nothing but is an art, right? Now, to do the thing with the people in a formal organized group. Formal organized group means the company has different sections. Different sections mean different departments. Different departments have the different people who have the expertise of that particular job. Now, the management will take care of those people. That what job should be given to the different group of people so that they can perform the job in proper manner. Or else, if I am doing giving the assignment of finance to an HR department, then they will not do the work. They cannot do the work, right? So it is the duty of the management to choose the particular job and give the particular job to the particular department. Now, in this section here, the transformation of data into information. This is an important aspect. Now, in the computer science, in the management, everywhere those things are used. So the first thing is coming to data. Okay. Now I am telling another thing, right? Data, new data, old data, not relevant data. Those are irresponsible statements, right? Data means data. I don't know that when those irrelevant data will come in play and give me the huge amount of revenue. I don't know, right? So data means data. And stock, you consider about the stock market. The huge amount of data is generated every day. Huge amount. Even you cannot imagine the amount of data the stock market every day generates. And the aeroplanes black box. You might have know the black box of aeroplane. It is a device which is there in the cockpit of the aeroplane, and it gives the all the information of the aeroplane whenever the aeroplane is crashed. Now, why it has been crashed? What happened? Is there any technical fault? All sorts of things. When the investigation team has the investigates regarding the accident of the aeroplane, they first try to find out the black box of the aeroplane. Now, those black box, those stock market, lots of things, they are generating huge amount of data. The question arises, if I have a computer system and my computer system has a limited space, then the stock market generates that much amount of data in terms of TV per day, terms of TV more than that also.
then how can I store those data? How can I manage those data? How can I manipulate those data? How can I edit those data? That is very important thing nowadays. Now, for that purpose, another technique is there in the computer science era, and department or computer science engineers there have the another application, which is known as the big data analysis and the Hadoop data analysis, and also all other softwares are also there. And those softwares are responsible to analyze those data, those huge amount of data, right? Now, come to our topic, that is data. Now, we capture the data from the environment. Now, the data is being transferred for the processing. Data is coming for the process, and process, after the processing of data, it convert into information. Now, this processing section is an important one. Why that is an important one? Now, let's say person A is a manager of a particular institution, private institution, and the person B is a manager of a particular bank. Now, they have the name and the phone number of different group of people. Now, what they do? The institution of people, that is the person A, required the phone number of the people, of the students who are in the study, who are in the process of study. Now, in the bank section, the manager required the data who are in the service section, right? Now, this transaction process is an important thing, and it substantially varies. For the, let's say, for the banking, it is the, it finds out the person who are in job sector or who are in income sector. But in the institution case, who, the person will look at the who are the name or the name and the phone number of the people who are in the students, right? Now, those are converted into information, right? Information, after converting the information, now after that we are taking the decision. Decision means, let's say manager, bank manager, call a particular person, and the particular person says that, yes, I will come to your branch, and regarding the loan, you will tell me that, so that if it is possible in my part, then I will accept and I will take that loan. Now, decision making is the session when the particular person comes to the premises of the bank. Now, the person coming to the bank, here decision is taken by the whom? The person as well the bank manager. Whether the bank will give the loan that particular person or not, or if the bank is giving the loan, whether the particular person is willing to take it. Now, after that decision making, then action will be taken. Action will be then bank either will say, the bank will say that yes, I will give the loan, or bank will say no, I will give the loan. I will not give the loan. Now, again, same thing in the customer side. Yes, I will take the loan. No, I will not take the loan. Now, this is the conversion of data and how it converts into the action, right? Now, coming to the functions of management. What are the different functions of the management? Acha. Previously, we learned that management has been defined as the process of getting things done to others. Now, managers don't do any work. Management do the work by others. Now, the, what are the different things the management will do? Now, number one is the planning. Planning is the process of thinking about the activities required to achieve a desired goal. Desired goal. Please try to understand the meaning of the statement. Desired goal, I'm taking again taking the reference of that bank manager. The desired goal of the bank manager is to provide the loan to the people, right? Now, bank manager may or may not, generally bank manager do not give any call for the loan. The different persons or the subordinates of the bank manager, they give the call. And the person comes to the branch, then the manager will talk with him that this is the interest, so and so, we will give this facility, blah, blah, blah. Then the person, then decision will be taken later on. Now the aim is to provide the loan. The sole motto of the bank is provide the loan, right? Now after giving the loan, the bank's objective is achieved. Now for the giving the loan to the different people is the, for doing that, they do lots of things. They're tracking the person, they know what is the job that person is doing. They know, they try to know that what if that if you are providing the loan to that particular person, will it be better for us that that person will return that loan in time or not? Lots of things they will study. Okay, now planning is the most important thing. Now it is the first and foremost activity to achieve the desired result. The first and foremost activity to achieve the desired result. After that is the organizing. Organizing is the classification and characterization of the request of the objective. Achha. Organizing means, let's say previously I give you the example of classification of data, right? Now here they classify if the person is eligible for the Krishi Rin, or the, if the person is eligible for personal loan, or if the person is eligible for any kind of house loan or some other thing. That is the classification and characterization and categorization of different sections. Now, third thing is direction. Direction telling us the people what to accomplish and see that they do it to be finished of their capability. Achha. Directive the council, what the directive tells? The directive telling the people what to accomplish, what to complete the thing. How to complete the thing, the directive thing will give you the detailed information. Now after that, the starting. This is the most important thing, the starting. Starting is an important concept in management as well as software industries also. Now, software engineering is an important content in the computer science where the companies give the particular decks to the particular kind of people. As we all know, might we know, that if there is a campus selection, the company selects lots of people, and the lots of people are not only for the coding part, right? Some are for the coding part, some are for the testing purpose, some are for the ER diagram purpose, lots of things are there. And accordingly, they characterize the staffs and put them in the different sections. And like for the, if you think about the managerial point of view, then if the person is the specialization in finance, and the person is the specialization of HR, and the person is specialization in IT, now accordingly they choose or they fit that person in the particular department. Now staffing functions require recognition of human resource need. Now human resource need. That's right. Try to understand the human resource. Human resource need. Now if you move to another country, for example, let's say Dubai, people from India migrate to Dubai for doing the job. And if the person, particular person is doing here the plumbing job, he and she will get here less money rather than he is getting more money in Dubai. Why that happened? Have you ever wondered that why Dubai people give pay them more money? And the main objective to pay them more money is the recession of the human resource in Dubai, right? Dubai had the less human resource, so that's why when people go from India to Dubai, now they have the huge amount of money provided to them, right? Now, last one is the controlling. Now, controlling part is the top manager's hand. Control is the course of action that measures present performance and guides it towards some determined goal, right? Controlling is the guiding to the company to achieve the particular type of goal. Okay. Now coming to the level of management, you might have known the level of management, the top level management, middle level management, and low level management. Top level management are those management consisting of board of directors, managing directors, or executive committee members, right? Now, what is their objective? Objective is setting key objectives, policies, identifying the factors, etc. for their organization. Then making appointment to the top positions in the organization. Then reviewing the work of different person in the various levels. Now here, if we thinking about the in the what the college point of view. Now the top level management may be the principal, the vice principal, right? and the academic process, those are the top level managers. They will take care, maybe they will be identified or they will recruit the different HODs or different senior lecturers and assistant professors. They will recruit. I am giving you an example. That is not the proper thing, right? Now, middle level management managers are the HODs, right? Now, the middle level managers consist of managers from various departments, like HOD in the department, plus the manager in the various department in the company, like the sales, marketing, then resource, finance, etc. Now, what are the objectives? Now, follow the rules and policies formed by the top level management. Whether the rules have been formed or not, governed by the different people or not, they will take care of that thing. Motivating the different persons so that they will do their work. Also, they are the messengers of the their subordinates to the top managers, right? There must be some hierarchy, right? The top manager communicates with the middle manager and the middle manager will communicate with the lower manager. Now, we should not move, or the communication should not move from the lower manager to the top manager. They move through the middle manager. It will be better for the company, right? Now, mutual understanding with the department in the organization, this point. The fourth point is the recommendation to the top level manager. Recommendation means, let's say, for the production in the production department, machinery are the less efficiently doing this work. Now, this middle level manager give the recommendation to this top level manager, sir, this machine at the older machine, having the 10-year back machine, we should replace this machine with the another machine so that our product will be increased. The production will be increased. So this recommendation can be given by the middle level manager to the top level manager. And the last one is the low level manager. Low level manager consists of the supervisors, and you can say that the head of the laborers, yes, union leaders, those are the low-level managers. Whatever, follow the rules and guidelines made by the top-level authorities by the organization. Now, the low-level management will obey the guidelines made by the high-level manager. Now, whether they are obeying or not, that thing should be taken care of by the middle-level manager, right? The classification and design jobs to be the worker, classify and design. Classify and design, when try to understand. The supervisor is well associated with the different group of workers. Now, which worker is better for which job, that particular supervisor knows. So that's why he divides the job in different groups. Okay. The direct and guide of the workers about their work procedure. The arrange to arrange the for the necessary tools, equipment, materials, etc. for the worker to solve the problem of the worker. These are the general things that you know, right? Now, coming to the system. Okay. What is system? A system is a group of interconnected components working together towards a common goal by accepting input and the processing and give the output for the organization, right? Now, system, what is the system? System will take the data, process it, and give the desired output. If the output is appropriate what we think, then the system is a good system. Now, the concept of system, inside the concept of system, we have the technology. Technology, inside the technology, you can use technology means currently if you are talking about the technology for the MIS, now that MIS technology basically for the computer, right, and the internet. And try to understand that Infosys, take an example, I am talking, Infosys has various offices in different parts of the world, right? Now, if Infosys acquires a particular project in USA, and the development or the development section of a particular project can be done here in Bhubaneswar also. Now, question arises, how the things can be done? Only things can be done when we are connected with each other, right? Connected with each other means it is nothing but the internet. Okay. the internet, which allows us to exchange the information or exchange the data so as we can generate the new version of work culture, right? Also, technology may be a software, technology may be a telecommunication device, technology may be the hardware. Now, I'm take an example of hardware component. Now, guys, whenever you are purchasing or downloading from software from the internet, below that software, you might have seen the hardware and software requirements have been written. If you have not noticed, now whenever further you download any software, try to notice those things, the requirement of software and hardware things, right? Now, that software minimum requirement is this. Software requirement is this, and minimum hardware requirement is this. Now, take an example. If you have a Windows 7 operating system, and you are buying that Windows 7, genuine version of Windows 7, now upon that packet, you will see that it will ask minimum hard disk capacity, minimum 40 GB hard disk, or 1 GB or 2 GB of RAM, and lots of things are there. The graphics card should be there, lots of things it will give to you, the instructions required, the hardware components required for installing that operating system in a computer, right? Now, second one is the application. Achha. Application means, currently guys, we are doing business, we are not doing business by selling the goods to the end customers, right? We try to doing the business sitting at remote place and trying to sell our product at thousands and lakhs kilometers away from our place. Now the business strategy has been changed. Now previously I was taken a class of I think social media and internet. There one important content of social media is to improve the business. Now how the social media improve your business? It is one application, example of your application. Now let's say whenever you are shopping a particular product in Flipkart, whether you are buying it or not buying it, forget about that thing. Only to shop a particular object, let's say particular type of shirt, you are looking at your Flipkart. Now you out of the Flipkart, and after 3-4 hours or 1 day, 2 days ago, after that, whenever you open your Facebook account, definitely you will find that particular kind of shirt, right? Now, have you ever think why it is being done? How it is being done is very important. Why not important, but how is it very important for technical point of view, right? Why it is being done is for management point of view, and the technical point of view is how it comes to our Facebook service. Now, this is known as the machine learning technique, which is another a wing of artificial intelligence. That means our computer is so intelligent so that if a person is looking at particular person, particular object, now the intelligent computer recognize that particular thing and take it and put that particular thing on that particular person's Facebook account. Now nobody involved within that process, right? And that is the main important of application. Okay. Now coming to the development. Achha. Development means you are trying to do a business, right? Trying to be a business, that doesn't mean you go buy the product and want to sell. Rastapati, I am a product, you will not do like that. As an educated person, you should do your business in another level, right? Now for that reason, what we do, we just have techniques, we just have the internet connectivity, we just have the computer system. Now can I use those things to do my business? Yes. Here the development sector gives us the idea regarding this. That developing way to use the IT business includes designing the basic component of the information system. Now, what are the basic component of the information system? Now, basic component of the information system is that you should collect the data of the particular people, Now, if you are doing a business, means your targeted customers are who? Whether they are the lower middle class, the middle class, the upper middle class, the very rich people. You should give the target audience to your product. Now, your product is selling, you are able to sell your product or not able to sell your product, that is another thing. Take an example, you might have seen the company name Billion, right? In Flipkart, you have the, just after that session, you saw the Billion white show, you have a Billion refrigerator, Billion AC, you just search. You might have not seen that product in any shops here in your locality. Now, where that company comes from? The problem is that the company don't have any marketing strategy and Flipkart don't have any particular product. Now, when that company and that particular product group together, they combinedly sell their product, right? And combinedly sales means they both have the generate the revenue. Okay. Now, management. Management, the top level manager and the managerial people, they sit behind and make the different strategy by looking at different data or different information that the system has been gathered. That is very easy, very important to gather the information in a shorter period of time. Only using the IT, information technology, the thing can be done. Correct? It will not. Okay. Now, next. Component of the system. As you should know that if you go through the fundamentals of computer, the fundamentals of computer gives you idea that a computer takes the input of the data, process the data and gives the output. Everything has this, not a fundamental of computer, in our life also. Everything you give as an input to a system, that system processes it and gives you the desired output. Whatever you think, these three processes should be involved within that, right? It is very important, characteristics of good information. Now, because we are reading the MIS, Management Information System, so we must have known the different ideas regarding the different things regarding the information and the data. Achha. The first characteristic is relevance. Okay. Now, take an example. Let's say you want the data of the people who are buying a particular kind of product. Particular kind of product, let's say what product? Samsung mobile phone, let's say. Samsung mobile phone. Now, question arises, you give your personnel or the employees the task that collect the information of the different people who are using the Samsung mobile phone. Now, the people searching market, move to the market, collect the different people's name and give them their form. And if they ask, sir, please kindly fill up your name, mobile number, and what kind of set you are using and which company it is. Right? Now they collect that sheet and come to their home. Right? Now people might use Samsung phone, people might use MI phone, people might use OnePlus phone, people might use any other phone. The relevant data is that particular page or particular sheet where the customer written Samsung. Now in the other way, if I am giving a particular people to a form and that person says that no, I am not using that phone. Now this is the irrelevant data. That means the person is not using the data. Relevant data means why Samsung is collected the number of customers using Samsung mobile. Because Samsung wants to make a strategy to sell maximum goods to maximum people. How they make the strategy? Only they know the number of customers in the market. Out of 100, how many are using the Samsung mobile, right? Now second one is the accuracy. Accuracy is pinpoint thing. Whether that, let's say 10% people are using Samsung phone, whether 10% is accurate data or anything manipulated over there, that is very important, right? And completeness. Completeness means the data should be completed, right? Completed in the sense, you should not provide the data which is not completed, right? The complete data will give complete information, right? If the complete data is not given, then the complete information will not be, right? Now, fourth one is confidence in the source.
Gotcha.
Lots of people are doing their researches in different fields, and for the research purpose, the internet is the best source to collect the data or information, whatever is there. And the different sites are also available. And among the different sites, I am talking about two sites, let's say. One is your Wikipedia. All of you know that name of the site, Wikipedia, right? And another site, let's say, as a technical person, I am talking about the IEEE, has a particular kind of website, IEEE site. Now, if, let's say, I am doing a research regarding a particular kind of chip, right? And that particular kind of chip has the information in here in the Wikipedia, as well as the particular research paper is there in the IEEE site. Now, if I am taking a particular paragraph from Wikipedia, that source is not trusted for me. But the trusted source is, if I am taking a particular research paper from the IEEE site, that is the particular source. And at the end, I can give the name of that particular paper. Because that is the trusted source, no bother about giving that name of that paper. But why we are not considered Wikipedia as a trusted source? Now, again, here the data and information comes in play. Wikipedia is an open source. Open source means anybody can access, anybody can manipulate, anybody can change the data. If you know, you can create your own Wikipedia account, you can able to change. Let's say you say that a human body has this much, let's say, two eyes, if they are written. Now, you can write that human body has three eyes. Let's say third person, if he is a layman, if he is wanting to know how many eyes human have, and Wikipedia says that three eyes, now that person knows that three eyes human have. Now, information will be wrong. But written in Wikipedia, and wrongly written by someone else, so Wikipedia is not a trusted source for the information, right? Now, communication to the right person. Okay, communication to the right person, that means, if you are collecting the data and if you are collecting the information, you should give those information to a particular person who can actually use that information. You should not give the data who don't have any idea what to do with that information. Right? So you should give that particular information to relevant person or right person. Okay? Now, next step. What are the different functions? First one is reduction of uncertainty. Function of uncertainty means if I have data, then I can take care of my customers. I can take care of the feedback of my customers. If feedback is maximum negative, then I can change my production line. Then again, I can put that product in market. Again, I take the feedback of the customer. Now I see gradually the feedback of the customer is negative to positive changing. If I am not taking the feedback of the customer in a particular time interval, then my product one day it will vanish. Nobody will use my product. If my product vanish, my company vanish. If my company vanish, lots of people, their job losses. Right? So, reduction of uncertainty means certainty, you should find out what to do. Uncertainty exists where there is less than before knowledge. Right? If not, you have knowledge, here, the you have knowledge regarding your customer, then you can increase the good quality data, right? And A2, monitoring and control. By providing information about the performance and the extent to deviation from plan level of the performance, management are better able to control operation. Management should have proper monitoring system to the different sections or different departments of its organization. So, which department has the less functionality, which department has the most functionality, then the management will take the decision, right? Then third one is as a means of communication. The communication is a very important aspect in any kind of organization. Now, if there is no communication, that means you will have the different the
company has the lack of different revenue generation problem, right? Then fourth one is as a memory supplement. Achha. By having the historical information, that means if I have the data of the stock exchange before the 10 years or before the 20 years, then I can know the future prediction of that particular data, particular kind of company. Like you have watched the cricket, and inside the cricket match you have seen the graph and also the prediction also there, that the winning prediction of India or winning prediction of Australia or New Zealand, they have predicted by looking at the previous data of this match. The particular match, the previous data, looking at the previous data, they predict the particular kind of thing. Whether the company will, sorry, whether the match will be owned by a particular country. Now coming to the information system. Now look at the diagram. This diagram gives you the input, processing, output, and during that processing, storage is the asset, and from the output of feedback is the asset again to the input. Now what happens? When you give the input has been processed. After processing, the data has been stored here in the storage device, and again that processed data gives the output at the end user. Whether that end user present here accept the data or not, then it gives the feedback to the input again. Right. So, whether the input data is correct or not correct, the feedback from this output when it comes to this input section, then only the data can again be processed and output again be generated. Now, this is for the accuracy purpose. The feedback section is only for the accuracy purpose. Until and unless the accuracy of the data is not there, then again feedback system is there. Right? Here, this system is always there. Now you have heard the Odisha government, Mo Sarkar, right? Why that Mo Sarkar? Mo Sarkar is only for the reduce the corruption in the system, right? If somebody is taking bribe from you, then you can call that particular number, right? Again and again, when Google the feedback, then again and again the corruption will decrease in the system, right? Okay. Now an information system can be any organized combination of people, hardware, software, communication software, and a data resource that collects transformation or streaming the information in an organization. So that's what I told here, right? A business is an example of an organizational system to an economic resources, that is input, is transferred by various business processes into goods and services, which is the output. Now, the economic resources are the input to the business organization, and the goods and services are the output of the business organization. Now, here I am giving one example of Oyo Hotels, right? Oyo Hotels, initially Oyo, if you have heard the speech of the CEO of Oyo, then the main objective of Oyo is that people will not panic whenever they are going from their place to any other place for any purpose. Whether they are going for the amusement purpose, whether they are going for any medical purpose or any other purpose, if they are wanting to stay there, then within 2 minutes they can book the hotel. That is the main objective of Oyo, right? Now, people have different backgrounds, higher class, middle class, lower middle class, then lower class. So people have different background, different economic background. Now, if as a OYO manager, if I am showing a hotel cost 10,000 rupees per night to a person belongs to the lower middle class, is it possible for that person start that you will stay there? Not possible. Possible in which case? Now, if OYO will give the information of 500 or 600 or 700 or 1000 cost of a hotel, then it is affordable by the person and the person will stay. Now here, the 1000 rupees cost is the services by the OYO,
And the economic resources is the 1,000 rupees, the economic background of that particular person. Understood? Now, coming to this point, some examples of the information system includes the following: airline reservation system. Inside that, what happened? Seat, booking, payment, schedule, boarding list, special link, etc. These are the different series of things that whenever you are booking a seat in an airline. Now, bank operation, deposit, transfer, or withdrawal. Right? Then, logistic management system, application to streamline the transportation of this. Right? Now, this is the example of different information system and how the systems are doing their job. Now, coming to the role of information system in business. Now, information system, how the information system plays the role inside a business, support the business process. Business process support. What happens when a business is being performed? Lots of things are required, and among those lots of things, one important thing is information regarding different aspects, right? Maybe the information regarding the rival of that company, maybe the information of the customers of that company, maybe the information of the market situation of that particular company, that should be known to the company personnel or the higher authority, so as they can take the necessary steps in order to make the streamline of that deficiency part, right? Second part is support operation of a business organization. Now, an information system supports operation of business organization by giving timely information, maintenance, and enhancement which provide flexibility in the operation of the organization. Right? Now, the support of the organization, support of the organization is different. It's timely information. Timely information. In particular time, that means, let's say, during this lockdown, people don't have, onion in the market. Yes. Now, if onion is not available in the market, but production of onion is sufficient, right? But availability is nil. That information should be reached in timely to the government, so that government will take the appropriate action. Or else, you will buy onion in 200 rupees per kg, what you have experienced earlier, right? Now, this is an example of support to operation for a business organization. Now, support to decision making. Obviously, if you have properly data and proper information, then you can take appropriate decision for your organization. Now, fourth one is strategies for an organization. Strategy means that if you are not the single company who is doing a particular kind of job or particular kind of product you are not giving in the market, lots of companies are there. Now, how you survive? This is a very important thing. How you will survive? If you will not survive, then your company will go down, your employee will go down, the morality of your employee will go down, and the belief and the faith of the employee to the top manager also go down, and the company will vanish. Now, for that reason, you should take care of the proper strategy, how to do the business in market, though I have number of rivals, though same thing has been manufactured by different companies. Now, I am giving a small example. Your gully has lots of shops, lots of grocery shops also. Now, lots of grocery shops, they are also selling. If they don't have the required sales, then they do not open that shop. Right? Now, what strategy they adopt? If you finally observe the talking style, the talking capacity of that shopkeeper, you will find that he wants to attract you. But again, say, look at that, you have to go to the city, But the words are something that attracts you. Now, if you are attracted, then you go regularly to that shop. if the walls are not affected, then you render that stuff, that stuff, that stuff. And the objective of that software, different shopkeepers, is to bind those customers for regular purchase. That anything they require, they should buy from my shop. Though there are 5, 6, 7, 10 numbers of shops in a particular region, still all are doing their business because they make their strategy. If you are good strategy maker, then you are the winner, right? Then come to the MIS application, applications in organization. What applications organization are adopting by using that MIS? First, look at the concepts of information. Data is the raw material for the information system. Collection of data costs money. I'm talking about an informal thing that there is a Telugu film previously I have watched in television. I don't remember the name of the film, but that film is regarding that a particular group of people, what they are doing, they are stealing the mobile number mobile numbers of that people, and that those numbers are associated with their bank account, and by looking at and by taking that mobile number, they take the money from the account, right? Now, if you have a huge amount of data, then you have the huge amount of money also. Now, first, I have told you, the most important and most costliest thing in the universe is the time and the data. If you have a good time player, you are the winner. If you have a good quality of data, you are the winner. Okay. The data is generally input to the information system for processing. Data size is also growing, but useless unless it is processed to the creation machine. But the data are useless until and unless it is not processed. Okay, when the data is processed, then it is good for everything. If the data is not processed, it is good for nothing. Right? Now, information is the processed data used by managers to initiate actions and to run the organization efficiently. Both things we have discussed, some parts we have discussed, something we know now. Now, here are the types of information. This is an important thing. Types of information are strategic, need for long range planning and direction. Okay, strategically, need for long range planning. Long range planning means you cannot say that for 10 years, 20 years, not like that. If you plan something for 2 years, it will not last 2 years because better plan available in other companies, they are doing much better than you. Now, where are you? You are 2 steps back from them. You have to compete. Nothing is permanent in business, right? With a small example you take, you have seen the different departmental stores. Departmental stores, I am talking about regarding, except Peter England is a brand, right? You can see the outlet, the outlet. The outlet of a particular brand is also available. And that particular outlet, you can find the, all the products belong to the Peter England. Now, the brand Peter England has the product in different shops also. Now, question arises, if Peter England provides the goods to the different shops in the different cities, then why it is required for the Peter England to open their own outlet? Isn't it? Abhushekha phone for land, is there outlet for you? Now, here the biggest question. Now, requirement is, listen the answer. Requirement is, every company wants to associate with their customers, right? Every company wants to associate with their customers. Now, how they will be associated? Now, if Peter England sells the product through another shop, will the Peter England will associate with these customers? No. Only when Peter England direct sends the product to the customer, then only he will know what are the customers review regarding that product, and accordingly they change their strategy, right? So you definitely don't think that the statement here, the strategy need for long range planning. This is not so much that much 2 year, 3 year, 5 year, not like that. It may be last 2 days also. But yes, we believe that long range planning should last something what we expect, until and unless the second company don't have the better plan than us, right? Then tactical, need to take short-term decision. Short-term decision is COVID-19 situation arises. Now, the company take their different short-term strategies. Now, within 2 months or 3 months, what should we do so that our sale will be increased? That is short-term strategy. Okay. Now, the operation, need for day-to-day operation of the organization, that is daily sales, billing, etc. You are buying something from the Big Bazaar, Vishal Mega Mart, or anywhere else. Now, the sales, what is the amount of sales? Every day they calculate it. Obviously, a particular person, you are not sitting and calculating, computerized thing has been done. Okay. Now, at the end of the day, the store manager knows what is the quantity, number of sales, or what is the amount that we sell today. Now again, they want to achieve more than that. Okay. And for taking that record, they have the better MIS application in their stores, right? Then statutory, need by law. Okay. Everything is not beyond the law. Okay. What we do, we should think about law. Okay. Now, a small example of law, not relevant to your topic, it is another thing, social issue. So, there is an article of 30A in the Indian Constitution. Right? We don't know. Yesterday only I know that regarding the two articles. But Article 30 gives you the idea that no Hindu can be allowed to teach the Hinduism in different institutions. But in 30A, gives the permission to any Muslim, any Christian, or any other religion in India to teach their religion in different institutions. So that is the law we have to know. Okay, we have to know the different laws in our constitution. Basic laws we have to know, right? Now, coming to the objective of MIS. What are the objective of it? We are using the MIS in our companies. What should be the object? Data capturing. MIS capture the data, various internal and external sources of organization. Achha. What is the internal and what is the internal sources? Internal sources means if you move inside the company, right? External sources means companies have the different outlets in the different cities, and what the people think about that company, that is the external sources. Data capturing may be manual or through computer terminals. Manual means, like previously I said, that give a paper sheet to different persons, ask them to give their feedback, and again, after that you are collecting the information manually. But in computer terminology, you might have seen different pages arises on your Facebook page that give the feedback regarding this. Now you are giving that survey, right? That is the computerized data they are collecting. Store information, MIS stores the processed or unprocessed data for the further use, right? Retrieval of information, MIS retrieves information from the stores as and when required by the various users, right? Okay. Disseminate of information. Information which is finished product of MIS is disseminated to users in an organization. It is periodic or online through a computer. Achha. What happened? Now the survey team, they do lots of things. Okay. Lots of things in terms of how they reach to the people. How could they reach the people? Number one, manual. Number two, online.
in this scenario, currently what scenario we are here we could not move to the customer's house, rather than we can reduce by virtual place. Virtual place is online place, right? Characteristics of MIS. Number one is system approach. The information system follows the system approach. System approach means a particular organization has a particular structure, and that particular structure should be maintained for that MIS, right? Management oriented means the company or the manager, what they actually want, accordingly the MIS should work, right? Need-based means what actually my company requires, accordingly that MIS should do. That's why it is a good characteristic for MIS, that it is a need-based thing. Then exception, another thing is error, right? Exception and error. Error is something which you cannot again rectify, right? But exception which you can handle or which you can rectify. That's why MIS can rectify the exceptions, right? Now future oriented, by looking at the previous data, it will predict other future aspects of your institution. And integrated in the sense, lots of data when coming together, the MIS would able to group them and give the particular output as the company required. Then common data flow in the sense, duplication of data, let's say some example. Class have two people having the same name, and the teacher called one name as Ram, then two people will respond. The problem arises, actually the teacher called one person and two people are responding to the teacher. But the teacher said, no, you are not you, please come here. That is the duplication of data. And that duplication of data inside the MIS, also inside the database, it is taken care of in very, very efficient manner, or else the system will not work appropriately. See? Now, for that reason, what happened, if two persons have the same name, but they are assigned a different roll number, okay? Now, that role system will identify that roll number, not the name. So, this is the primary key in the database, that the primary key when read, the primary key, which is the roll number field, is read. And again, that the primary key will update all sorts of fields of that particular person, not the name, right? Then after long-term planning, previously I am telling that nothing is long-term in the business. Everything what you are doing, all are in a short term, right? So, what you do, you should think, yes, it is for long-term, but generally you should prepare your mind, nothing for the long-term, but your MIS credit for the long time planning, right? Achha. Characteristics of computerized MIS. As earlier, if you have in the year of 19, have you ever been in bank? If somebody there in bank in 1995 to 1993, then you can see that the bank persons, they are maintaining the account of different persons in a copy, right? Name is written there, amount is written there. Now if I am going to withdraw my money, they have to return there, calculate the interest amount, lots of things they are doing, okay? If I am withdrawing 1,000 rupees, then it will take them half an hour. Now if currently if you are going to bank to withdraw 1,000 rupees, even you need not to go your branch. Only you need to go the nearest ATM. All sorts of things are taken care of by the computer. That's the beauty of the computer. That's the beauty of MIS, that gives us the flexibility of use of the system. Right? Achha. The characteristics of computerized MIS, it should be able to process data accurately. It gives the processing of data accurately, high speed with least error. You should be able to collect, organize, manipulate and update large amount of raw data, which
on the point of view of for a human being, it is very difficult to do all sorts of things. And third thing is, you should provide real-time information. You should support various output from us and from latest rules and regulations in practice. अच्छा लेटेस्ट फॉर्मेट जो फ्लो फॉर्मेट है लेटेस्ट फॉर्मेट देर इज एक टर्म कॉल्ड फ्लो डायग्राम एंड डाटा फ्लो डायग्राम डीएफटी द डीएफटी कैन ऑल्सो बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन एमआईएस यू शुड प्रोवाइड ऑर्गेनाइज एंड रिलेवेंट इंफॉर्मेशन यू शुड एम एंड एक्सट्रीम फ्लेक्सीबिलिटी इन डाटा स्टोरेज एंड स्ट्रक्चर right these are the characteristics of computerized MIS that is what you are doing in normal or regular MIS what you are doing in regular and manual MIS whenever you are using a computer the acceleration the manipulation the updation the organization all things are speed up when all things are speed up then your productivity will also automatically speed up when productivity speed up your revenue will more speed up right okay limitation of the MIS limitation of MIS is the MIS is good only when does it design in well structured manner if it is not designed in well structured manner it is not a good and again another thing is for running the MIS you should have personnel who have skilled regarding this skill means this is not the out of box thing right this is a general thing the person needs to know how to operate this right if you sit in front of a computer based MIS then hardly 7 to 5 days you will be expertise, right? Nothing big deal to do, okay? Now another thing is the MIS is nothing without data. If no data, no MIS. And no data is telling means no data means the world is just like a dump. Without data, the world is a dustbin, right? Okay. Sakhal uchlaru dakti soila jai. We all are associated with a huge amount of data. Apan mane bhabuchanti ki na bhabuchanti, it is matterless. But every day, you are generating a huge amount of data. And again, whenever you are sleeping, if you think from the starting of the morning to the end of the day, what thing I did, now you think you may not remember those things that I did. But a single day of data, apan mane kapatare monna na bhabuchanti. Now, same thing for avoid kaya thing, what we do, we just implement a computer system. And again, how manual computer system we are adopt corona. We are adopting an automated computer system. Automated in the sense, artificial intelligence enabled computer system. Artificial intelligence, the simplest example is your, if you have a latest model of refrigerator, then that also has the AI enabled refrigerator. Your what air conditioner is also a little bit of an enabled device. Like if you have set the temperature 24 degrees Celsius and if the room temperature is 24, automatically the compressor will stop. Again, if the temperature increases above the 24, then compressor automatically started. And this is automated system. What we want in our life, the things are being automated and we people are getting very lazy. Very lazy means very heavy. Very heavy means lots of diseases. Lots of diseases means lots of expenses in medicine. Lots of expenses in medicine means we focus to the work is less. Okay? So instead of doing that, you should have your focus on your health also. Okay? So I am stopping here. Himadji sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm stopping here. If you okay, have any questions,
then
they can ask me.
Yes, sir. Okay, dear learner, if any questions, you can ask through chat box, or you can unmute your mic and ask directly, please. लर्नर मानकर जदि किछि क्वेश्चन्स अछि से माने डायरेक्ट पचारि परिबे न हेले चैट बॉक्स थ्रू रे सान को क्वेश्चन पचारि परिबे I think, sir, there is no questions from any learner side.
I hope so.
Yes, sir. So, one thing I have learned from chat box, that is, today is your birthday. So, on behalf of OSOU and learners, I wish you for your good health, better future, and prosperity. So
thank you very much for your wish, sir.
One question from
yes, somebody is asking anything?
No, wishing you, sir. Wishing you.
Okay. Again, sir, thank you very much.
Sir, one question is are there. Each knowledge-based system, that is a knowledge recovery system, a knowledge-based system, is come under MIS or not?
Listen, sir. Knowledge-based system is nothing but what the human being have only the knowledge, right?
Yes.
Now thing is that when we implement that knowledge inside a computer, it is very difficult now and then for any researcher to implement the human brain inside a computer. But research is going on. But thing is that when we think about of a knowledge-based system, that knowledge-based system extract the information also. Now that information only required for the MIS only. Now before the data process, the processing thing, if you put a knowledge-based system, then only you can call it as MIS, no issue. Now your MIS system will be more increased version of performing the work.
Yes, sir. Okay, thank you, sir, for a brilliant class. We hope we'll meet again. And will all the learners meet in next class. Thank you, sir. Now we will close the session. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, sir.